I look outrageous right now. This is mid-camp, so it's a little bit... I'm in a phase now in my camp where I look like a mess, to be fair. I've got a horrible beard. I haven't had a cut in like 2 months. So, but we're getting close to the fight.
There looks to be some confusion from one. Little moments, you see the spinning
elbow. The son of an Olympic gold medalist may very well be a future world champion.
What's up, guys? Today I thought I'd show you a whole day of eating in fight camp. You know, when normally, obviously, I try to eat quite clean all the time anyway, but when I get ready for a fight, I need to make sure that I make a specific weight, and I have to lose weight for that, so everything gets a little bit more strict. So I'm going to show you a whole day of what I eat in the morning, evening, lunch, all my after training snacks, and all that kind of stuff. So let's get into it. So the first thing that I do in the morning is I take my supplements. These are all kind of vitamins and minerals and other natural plant-based supplements that help me function better. Obviously, with all the training that I do, my immune system is going to be weak, so I need to make sure that I kind of supplement it with extra stuff, especially nowadays our food is not that good. All the GMO stuff and the way it's grown and the way the meat is kept, and it's not going to be as healthy. So I need to make sure they get everything from outside as well, not just from my food. So I got my vitamin C's, my D's. This is seaweed extract. So this is seaweed basically. Here, this is my probiotic. You have to be careful with your probiotics because you need to make sure that your probiotic gets to your gut or to your stomach. Otherwise, it's not gonna work. So it has to be a good probiotic. This one is actually all these three are all nootropics, so my brain works better. And my last ones, these are my favorite ones, they raw liver and heart capsules. So because I don't have that much time between waking up and training, I try not to make a big meal. So I just usually do like a little shake, and I'm gonna show you what I put in that shake. I usually do some raw eggs and some egg whites. Now this one is a tricky one because I usually try to get raw milk. If I can't do that because I'm busy or it's taking too long from the farm to arrive, I usually get goat milk. Now the problem is that this is still pasteurized, so it kills out all the good bacteria. But from my experience, goat milk is still better for my gut than normal milk. So I try to use this. This is obviously, if you watch my previous video, this is a Perform protein powder. So I try to take these together and some, I don't even know how to say them, whether it's chia or chia seed, I don't know. Now before I start making all my food and all my supplements and all that kind of stuff, I need to make sure the vibes are good. Why would you want to start your day any other way?
Show you my best friend. I give you my last guy's friend. Everything I do, I wonder.
I need to make my training kind of supplements. So first I'm gonna make another same Perform Restore protein shake. So now the next thing that I'm gonna do is my pre-workout. So I personally don't like pre-workout, especially when you have caffeine and stuff like that. You have a little calm down after the perform active. Amazing, like literally you get the same kind of high as normal pre-workouts, but you're so much better. It's healthier, doesn't have caffeine in it, which you know you can kind of get addicted to. Don't get the calm down after, and again, if I can't even read all because it's a long list with all the stuff that's in it, but it is really, really, really good. And before every session I have it and I'm ready to go, it's actually nuts. So on days as well when I don't have breakfast, I have this and I'm just literally ready to go do my workout. So it's actually pretty nuts.
Norbert's up.
Oh shit.
Yeah, you can see us.
Did they hit me? Norbert's up. Pretty good, you know, for my hair down.
I hate this guy here, I hate him.
I'm gonna film a day of heat.
Where'd you get that from?
No one likes him in here.
The internet?
No one likes Norbert.
They can hear you.
It's a can. 11.
Ooh, Canelo.
I just held it back.
Bro. Yeah, right.
Yeah, so the first thing I do after training is have my protein, my Perform protein. Again, like this is the one I use in the morning, so it's full of good stuff. So I have this after my first session. This is the first part of my post-training rehydration. And once I'm done with that, that's when I'm gonna have my coconut water. Look outrageous right now. This is mid-camp, so it's a little bit, I'm at a phase now in my camp where I look like a mess, to be fair. I've got a horrible beard. I haven't had a cut in like 2 months. So, but we're getting close to the fight. But yeah, so after my protein, I have my coconut water. Finished my first session. Obviously, I had my rehydration stuff. This is my next part, this is my lunch. So I've got peas and pod, chicken and rice. I'm gonna have that cold because I don't wanna lose any nutrients. And then after that, I've got a banana.
I want a bit of chicken.
Yeah.
Bit of sweet potato,
yeah.
Bit of broccoli, bit of carrots. Yeah, that's the meal. That's the meal, boys.
I'm done with my food. Still got one session, so I'm just gonna have a nap, sleep in the gym, and then wait until my next session starts and continue with all the food stuff.
There's no space. He's fucking.
No, be careful, my knee.
Come here, you big boy. Come here, you big boy. We go?
Because I'm super tired from my last session, I'm going to take some glucose tablets. Especially, it's good when you're cutting weight because it's not a lot of calories and it just wakes you up a little bit. So I'm going to take that now before training. And second session starts. Yeah, so second session done. Usually I have electrolytes, creatine, glutamine, depends. At the moment I'm not taking anything really, but I'm not gonna have any food and I'm gonna go home and eat there. As you can probably tell, I'm really, really tired. Sometimes I do a little run, but today I'm feeling a little bit, so I'm not gonna do my run. But I'm gonna take you through my dinner. I'm so tired. I'm gonna take you to my dinner, which is quite basic. Even seasoning with the food, I can't really do too much. Because if I do too much seasoning, one, is going to be too many calories, and I'm trying to lose the weight. Two, I'm just too tired. It's past 9:30. Just got home, and I'm just really tired to do all the seasoning. So before anyone rips into me, those are my two reasons why my food is not that seasoned. So. Seasoned blends they can put on the chicken. I usually just marinate it for like half an hour-ish and then I put it in the air fryer. I've got the marinated chicken here. Again, as I said, I can't do too much. I need to watch the calories. Also, I'm really, really tired right now, so I just can't be able to do anything else. And I've got the sweet potato fries and broccoli, and I'm going to put all of this into an air fryer. Like earlier, we still need the vibes though, so I'm going to put some music on and I'll do all my cooking while listening to music, basically. Well, I'm not even going to be cooking, I'm just going to use the air fryer.
And we'll be sure that the lady is a friend.
And unfortunately, I have a really bad sweet tooth and I always need to have something for dessert. I'm going to show you what I have in a fire camp while I'm cutting weight for dessert, and hope you guys are gonna like it. Maybe you guys can use it. Yeah, so here I've got blueberries, apple, and some Greek yogurt, and some dark chocolate. And I'm gonna mix all of this together and have that for dessert once my chicken and sweet potato are done.
I'm making love to you. I saw the sun, the moon, the mountains and the rivers. I saw heaven when I made sweet love to you.
Yeah, so that was it basically. A day of eating. This camp, I started quite early. I haven't fought in 2.5 years. So I just wanted to make sure that I'm not messing anything up. So I started really, really early with my weight cut. Obviously, the more time I've got, the slower I can lose the weight. I've still got quite a bit of weight left and I've got 2.5 weeks to go. And then I'm just looking forward to the day when I knock this guy out and have some fat burgers with a milkshake. Oh.